so well enough. We tend to be masters of everything, but we can't. We need to be to start making choices, priorities, and in a way, that's a valid suggestion that we need to identify our strengths and harness those strengths. But in addition, that even if you do have weaknesses, that should also be a way for us to start asking: is it a real weakness because we don't really excel in it, because we don't like it, or is it because there's just a skill that we don't know yet, but we could develop it? So these are things that we need to eventually fine-tune. Innovation is really complex, but we have to start somewhere, and a plan should be there. We hope there should be a concrete plan. That's one of the things that we're sort of suggesting. Second is there cannot be single solutions for everything. I don't know. I think I shared this thought with Manette that sometimes we tend to focus too much on sectors. Well, let's do on sectors, this sector, rather than activities, helping, you know, focusing on innovative activities and supporting those innovative activities, quick wins. In a way, that's what he was suggesting, having identified quick wins, and also recognizing that there will be things that will take time. But it doesn't mean we shouldn't invest in these things, especially, as I said, when you look back at China, look at Korea, and they were all, and, you know, Min Ji-kyung, the president and dean of AIM, was telling me, we used to really think of Philippines as, wow. Of course, she didn't say anything now anymore. You could infer what she said. The same with my friends from Malaysia, many countries. They all say, you were all, what happened to you? Okay, but fine, we had bad politicians before decades, but that's past. So now let's look at the present, learn from the past, move on to the future. Thank you.